Carpentaria is a 2006 novel by the indigenous Australian author Alexis Wright. Wright was born in 1950, the daughter of a white cattleman who died when she was five, and a Waanyi Nation mother by whom she was brought up. She gained university degrees from Adelaide and Melbourne, then became a land rights activist, both inside and outside the government, becoming a multi-award-winning author along the way. In 2017, she was elected to the chair of Australian Literature at Melbourne University. Carpentaria won the Miles Franklin Award, Australia's top literary prize. It tells the story of a community of Aborigines, probably in the 1990s, although dates in the novel are hard to come by, in a fictional town called Desperance, in the real-life shire of Carpentaria, in far north Queensland. Desperance is divided antagonistically along racial lines. The white population constitutes Uptown, the Aborigines Pricklebush. Pricklebush is divided into three parts, represented by different elders. The novel's chief character, Normal Phantom, his enemy Joseph Midnight, and the nomadic Mozzie Fishman. The divisions are sharpened when a multinational mining company arrives in the locality and starts buying the collaboration of the locals. Midnight allows himself to be co-opted, Phantom doesn't. Even so, when one of Normal Phantom's sons, Will, becomes an activist and starts destroying the company's infrastructure, Normal's none too pleased. A warrant is issued for Will's arrest, but he evades capture by going on the road with Mozzie Fishman. Meanwhile, two of Normal Phantom's other sons go to work for the mine. Wright's portrait of Pricklebush is far from sentimental. All the Aborigines have a mystical streak, and they've managed to keep the stories and beliefs alive. But nowadays, those stories and the Aboriginal identity exist within the context of a radical social dislocation. The novel begins with Phantom's wife, Angel Day, scavenging on the town's rubbish dump, then confronting other Aborigines who arrive to compete with her. Normal Phantom has virtues. He's respectful of his community's traditions and loyal to his friends, but he's also pig-headed, prejudiced, and tyrannical. He doesn't like his son's activism to the point where he stops speaking to him. Even Will has his faults, but perhaps they arise from the fact, which the author hints at but never explicitly states, that he doesn't really know himself. There's a sense in which all the characters are globalised, from Will's, according to his father's southern black activism, to the Rastafarian music and clothing of the young men, to Mozzie Fishman's love of country and western tunes. They're part of an international community of dispossession and salvaged pride. Carpentaria is a long novel, and it isn't gripping. It may be best read as a series of tightly interconnected short stories, of which the best probably occurs in Chapter 8, An Ocean Funeral, which bears comparison with Hemingway's The Old Man and the Sea, not only in terms of subject matter, but also in terms of the quality of the writing. It would have been easy for Wright to make Carpentaria into a magical realist novel, but I think wisely she's resisted that temptation. Where supernatural figures do break in, they're usually presented as dreams the characters are having, which of course underlines the way in which the beliefs and traditions are still under threat of loss. I live in Britain. It's arguably hard for me to properly assess a novel about a culture many thousands of miles away, of which I'm perhaps shamefully ignorant. But I can say this, even with those limitations in mind, Carpentaria does feel very much like a great novel.